Hey guys, welcome back to my weekly videos. If you've never been to my page before, my name is Sarah. I'm a life coach and a mentor, and I make videos on faith-based content, self-development, life advice, and I just come on here and share my thoughts and feelings with you guys. First thing that I just wanted to say is I posted something on my Instagram the other day, just saying that there's been a lot of changes in my life recently with my personal life, with business, with new projects and stuff like that. So I just firstly wanted to say thank you so much to you guys, to my friends, to my family for being so understanding of my slow responses on social media and just in real life being a little bit absent. But it's all good changes. It's just a lot that's been going on and I can't wait to share it with you guys. But basically it's kind of tied into what I wanted to talk about today. So because of the fact that there's so much chaos going on around me, not in a bad way, but good chaos going on around me, it can be really easy to be overwhelmed. I'm just going to share some examples with you guys. I hope that this can be an encouragement to whoever is maybe dealing with a lot right now, there's a lot of busyness. Maybe you're a go-getter, maybe you're an entrepreneur, maybe you just have a lot going on in your life right now with work, with school, with personal, whatever it is. And I hope that this can bring some clarity and some relief as well. And then at the end, I'm also just gonna pray for you as well, whoever needs to hear this prayer. So I'm just gonna jump into it. Okay, so one thing that I wanted to say is that when I started off on Monday earlier this week, I had this really long to-do list. And the first thing that I would think to do is to just get everything done as quickly as possible and just kind of like go for it. And I don't know, not everyone is like this, but I'm kind of the type of person where if I need to get things done, I'll speed walk through the mall. I drive faster than I should to the mall. I am doing everything with a feeling of anxiety and angst because it almost feels like then I'll get things done faster. So what I kind of decided to do, and this is kind of my piece of advice if you are feeling overwhelmed with a lot, is to actually intentionally slow down. Even though you're feeling like you're getting less done, you're actually not. And someone actually commented on my Instagram post because I did that post about just kind of sharing where I'm at in life right now. And they actually said, sometimes you need to slow down to speed up. And shout out to that person for that comment. I was like, yeah, that's actually so good. I'm gonna incorporate that into my video. Another thing that came to me as well is that Jesus was never in a hurry. And when I think about myself or any of us running around and being anxious and trying to get things done, anxiousness is a form of fear, and fear is not trusting. So if I trust the Lord that He has me, that He has everything aligned for me, and that He knows what's best for me, then if I'm running around anxious and hurrying, then I'm not fully trusting that He has everything laid out for me. Another thing that I thought of, which I think a lot of us can relate to, is you know when you spent so much time worrying about something and being so frazzled, and then you look back and you're like, oh man, I wish I could have just enjoyed that time, and I wish that I just could have relaxed more and knew that everything was going to be worked out for me. And that's something that's a reminder as well that I try to keep in mind, is that I don't want to look back at this time of my life and say, wow, I wish that I could have been more present and I could have just enjoyed more. And again, that's for all of us with whatever we're going through. Another thing is also remembering that God gives us perfect peace. He promises that He will give us a peace that surpasses all understanding. And that's one of my favorite things of having a relationship with God, is that there can be a whirlwind and a chaos all around us, but we can feel peaceful and content. Even though in the natural, we're looking at things and it doesn't look like it's gonna line up or it's gonna come through, or it's gonna make sense. But the thing is that God's ways, they don't always make sense. And there's this quote that I heard the other day, or I heard a little while ago, something along the lines of, though God's activity can seem unpredictable, His character is constant. And we know that He is good and that He is for us. And so when we know that, we can have a peace that these things are gonna work out. Another thing is remembering that if God calls us to something, then He is going to ensure that that thing comes to pass and that He is going to bring us through it. He's not going to give us something that is too much for us to carry. And obviously it's different if we're just doing everything that we want and we're walking in our own will. But when we're praying and we're asking, what is Your will for my life? And then we're feeling a peace about a decision that we're making, and we're not jumping ahead. and we're not running ahead, we're not making all of our own decisions, we're not doing just what we think is best, we're actually waiting and being patient, and we know that that's something that God has called us to, then we know that He is going to bring us through us as well. He's not going to call us to something and bring us so far just for us to fail. Another thing that I wanted to share is that one of my friends sent me a very, very, very timely message that I wanted to also share with you guys that all ties in together. And I really believe that God spoke through her to share this with me. And it's an excerpt from the Bible. So first of all, I have the cutest Bible. It's a She Reads Truth Bible. But anyways, this is what she reminded me of. So I'm going to read this part here of the excerpt. And it says, in Joshua 10, Joshua faces a firm deadline with a pretty serious agenda. Save his people from the attack of five powerful kings. It's a bleak situation until the Lord says, do not be afraid of them, for I have handed them over to you. Not one of them will be able to stand against you. Then she goes on to say that if she were Joshua in this situation, or let's just say if God were to assign her some huge project that seems overwhelming, the first thing that she would do is kind of just like get to work right away, like start hustling. But she's saying that's not what Joshua does. And she says, Joshua asks God to make the sun stand still, giving him time to fulfill the mission at once. And God does it. The sun stops in the middle of the sky, delaying its setting almost a full day and giving Joshua the time needed to accomplish his task. And then she says, I don't want to spend my days strategizing. I want to get busy living like God has called me to live. May we ask the Lord for a faith like Joshua's, boldly believing that God is in our corner. Let us stand and walk and live in the sunlight, knowing that He is for us. So that's what I wanted to share with you guys for today. It was just really important for me to come on here while I'm in the middle of my own good chaos and whirlwind, but nonetheless, it's still a lot. And I just wanted to practice what I preach, come on here and slow down, make a video, share this with you guys as I'm going through it, and maybe you are as well. And I just wanted to remind you that if God has called you to something, He is gonna see you through that. He's not gonna bring you so far just to have you fail. Remembering that Jesus was never in a hurry, and that when we're hurrying, it is a form of anxiousness, it is a form of fear, and that God has not given us a spirit of fear, that He has given us a sound mind. And that when we really do trust Him, then we can slow down and we can take our time, knowing that everything is going to come into order. And lastly, that will be one of my main prayers as well, is maybe not literally, but asking God to stop the sun for me and just stop time so that I have more time, and that He can supernaturally expedite things. So on that note, I'm just going to pray right now for whoever is going through this. If you want, you can pray along with me. You can close your eyes. You can bow your head. You can just listen. You can just say amen at the end and agree, whatever you feel led to do, but it is very powerful to come together and agree in prayer. Okay, so dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this opportunity to be able to even make videos in the first place and share messages. Thank you so much for the audience that is watching. Thank you for every single person who's watching this video under the sound of my voice. Lord, I just ask you that you touch their hearts right now, that you give them a peace right now as they're listening to this. Thank you, Lord, that just as I'm speaking, that they can even just feel in their hearts how much you love them. And if they don't know you, Lord, I just ask that they seek your face and that they pray and they ask you to reveal yourself to them. Thank you, Lord, that right now a lot of us, we have been going through a lot, but we know that you are with us. So whether it's, I don't know what everyone is going through, but whether it's just a lot of chaos, good or bad, maybe some people are overwhelmed with work right now, with relationships, with life decisions, with moving, with events. Maybe they're just battling with their own mental health right now, Lord, or with health issues physically in their body. But right now, Lord, I just ask you to give us a supernatural peace, to let us know that everything is going to be okay, to expedite things in your timing quickly. And we also just ask you, Lord, if we have a lot of to-do lists and things that we don't see how it's possible to do, we just ask you to make the sun stand still for us and to make time stand still, and that you can supernaturally expedite things very quickly for us. So thank you for allowing us to get everything done. Thank you that we know that whatever you have called us through, that you will bring us through it. And if there are things that you have not called us to that we're focusing on, we just ask you to remove those. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, guys, so, well, it's really bright in here now. Okay, guys, so thanks so much for watching. And if you like this video, please share it with someone. And again, I also have my coaching website. I'll put the link here. It's nowbloom.life if you'd like to book email coaching with me or one-on-one virtual coaching over the phone or over Zoom. So I will see you guys next week and love you. Bye.